gathered today to talk about some ideas, some rules, some equations that scientists have introduced to the world. And these ideas have shaped and have changed our understanding of the nature that surrounds us. We're gonna flow on these ideas from the beginning till the end. So if you allow me, I'm gonna start talking about one of the most mysterious forces out there, and that is the law of gravity. Our world is governed by the force of gravity. Gravity is the reason why I'm standing on the floor right now instead of just flying upwards. Gravity has played a major role in the biology of the human body, and in fact, life as we know it would not have existed without the force of gravity. Although it governs our everyday lives, the 100 billion members of our human species that have ever lived have struggled to understand its nature. In the 1900s, and at the age of 26, Albert Einstein was working as a clerk in the Swiss patent office. And only during his free time, Einstein was thinking about the universe, about the cosmos, about the stars, about time, about our gravity, about everything that surrounds us. His ideas contradicted Newton's ideas, so he had to come up with new models. He had to come up with new theories. According to Einstein's theories, the fastest thing there is in the universe is light. And light moves at the speed of 300,000 kilometers per hour. This is a very high speed. And for Einstein, nothing ever in the universe can exceed that force. Now we know that the sun is at the distance of 150 million kilometers from Earth. So every single light, every single photon you receive from the sun on Earth has actually escaped 8 minutes ago from the surface of the sun. But Newton had a different theory when it comes to gravity. And for him, gravity was a constant force. And assume, we all know that we have the sun, we have planet Earth. Planet Earth is orbiting around the sun. Now, let's see what's gonna happen to Earth if the sun vanishes. According to Newton, if the sun disappears for whatever reason, the Earth and the planet will instantly feel the disappearance of the sun. And thus the force of gravity will become zero instantly, in no moment, in no time. And thus the Earth will be moving along a straight line. But again, if we go back to Einstein, Einstein said that the speed of light acts as a cosmic limit. So if gravity moves instantly, then it is faster than light. And that's a great contradiction between the two ideas. So what Einstein did, he tried to measure the speed, the rate at which gravity moves. And when he did, he found out that the gravity moves exactly at the speed of light. So it will take 8 minutes for the Earth to feel the disappearance of the sun. And in order to talk further about Einstein's theories about gravity and light, we have to talk about dimensions. Now, any point on Earth can be located in three dimensions, that is the X, Y, Z dimensions. I can move forward, I can move backward, right, left, I can move up, I can move down. These are the three different dimensions that I can move on. This is the X, Y, Z. But consider the following fact. You have never met someone at a place unless it was at a time. And you've never met someone at a time unless it was also at a place. If I wanted to invite someone to this talk, I wouldn't say, meet me at LAU, Irwin Hall Auditorium, first floor. That's three dimensions. Well, what time should I meet you there? And this is how Einstein thought about this fusion between the dimensions. What he did is he fused the three dimensions of space, he fused X, Y, Z, and the one dimension of time. He fused them together and he gave us a four-dimensional continuum, and this is what he called space-time. This idea has changed our understanding of the universe and of the nature that surrounds us. And allow me to show you with this demonstration what I mean exactly by space-time and how it is related really to gravity. This blue fabric here represents the fabric of space-time. This is the three dimensions of space and the one dimension of time embedded together into what we call a space-time. Now it appears that the fabric of space-time, it is straight and flat because there's no matter on it. Now, if I take this sphere, it has a specific mass. And if I place it in the fabric of space-time, it's not a surprise that the fabric of space-time will stretch and bend. And the fabric of space-time right there is stretched and bent due to the existence of matter on it. Now, assume this time, this is Earth. If I put Earth, again, it will warp and bend the space-time. And let's assume that this little sphere right there is the moon. Now, the moon is, it has much less mass than the Earth does, of course. So if I present the moon in the vicinity of Earth, the moon will be orbiting around the Earth because it is locked in the valley that Earth has created due to its existence, due to its mass. And this is why the moon is orbiting the Earth today. It is because it is locked in that valley of the space-time that Earth have embedded on the fabric of space-time. This is the idea of gravity, according to Einstein. The moment I place the sun in the fabric of space-time, the moment I do this, the fabric of space-time will be stretched and it will bend. And if we assume that this sphere, in this case, is the Earth itself, now, once I place Earth in the fabric of space-time, Earth will feel the existence of the sun, and it will be locked in the valley that the sun has created due to its mass. Assume these marbles here resemble everything there is in the solar system. These are the planets, these are the moons, these are the asteroids, the comet, everything you can think about in the solar system is orbiting the fabric of space-time because they are all locked in the orbit that Earth has created due to its presence. This is why all of us are orbiting the sun right now. This is why all the objects in the solar system are orbiting the sun, because the sun is more than 90% massive than everything there is in the solar system. So it makes the maximum extension of the fabric of the space-time. It makes the largest valley in the fabric of space-time. And this is why you and I are stuck today in the gravity of Earth, because Earth has stretched the fabric of space-time and we are stuck in that valley that Earth has created. This is the space-time which was resembled on this fabric of space-time. This is the idea, this is the new idea that Einstein has presented about gravity. And the problem was finally solved when it comes to gravity, almost solved actually.